Reese comes back from off-screen squalor to announce a golf tournament at Wu Island, with the grand prize being two tickets for a trip to Brazil. SMG4 and Mario in particular enter the game access to the Guardian Pod stuck in the Rio Mountain. They're not the only ones to show up as three other teams join in. Bowser and Bowser Jr., Wario and Waluigi, and even Bob and Bootkins. Everyone plays golf in their own wacky ways, much to G's perfectionist dismay. It annoys him enough to change the rules, announcing Speed Golf, which is a race to the flagpole, not knowing this is supposed to be a game of Mario Golf. An exaggerated version of it, of course, but nothing like regular, bland, real-world golf. Jeeves angrily takes drastic measures after they messed up his game again by making them battle to the death. They refuse to give in to his sick desires and hold hands. The butler fork snaps and summons the Wii Sports legend, Matt. While everyone teams up to take him down, an epic fight occurs between him and rejected Waluigi, but the former is no match for the mimetic athlete. Glitchy being the last one standing, he's about to be thrown into the lava pit. Before he is greeted with a fiery death, he says that he just wanted to go to Brazil. This causes Matt to have a flashback of his younger years, when he dreamed of going to the same location. Yes, that means Matt is of Brazilian descent. He once told his dad, Tommy, that he wanted to go his home country, but possibly out of shame and whatnot, his dad said otherwise, and it's why he became an expert at sports. Matt lets SMG4 go and Thanos's Jeeves, turning him into tickets, and hands them over for his trip. The meme lord thanks the wise athlete and he flies into the sun. Only in the glitch verse does this make a bit of sense. 9.5 out of 10, near perfect episode. The golfing shenanigans that pay tribute to the Mario spin-off series along with the Matt Waluigi battle, well done. The characters and jokes, including minor ones like Jub-Jub and Psycho, are entertaining to watch. And the plot and pacing are great, even with the Summer Baxter, which is a cousin, is pretty silly. Let's try to make you sympathize with Matt. And Matt, great, I have it that it, I feel his flashback scene does go on for a bit longer than needed. So that's why I took a half point off. Regardless, this is a great video that parodies part of the Mario franchise and deserves a place in the Genesis arc. Whether it's considered a filler episode or not, oh, I do have one question about it though. Is this the last we see of Jeeves? I know he was quite a jerk here, but he's really gone? If not, where'd he go? Hope that gets addressed in the future.
It's relatively rare for modern game companies to police fans creating mods of their games, but it's nearly unthinkable for companies to police fans creating videos of their games. Who would even consider doing such a thing?
I'm surrounded by idiots.
An Undertale-themed intro tells about the red and blue duo venturing in the Brazilian mountains to find the USB. Yet their journey is interrupted with a visit to the realm of Newgrounds. What happens in Rio stays in Rio. I think it's what they say. So Mario and SMG4 trek through the following Flash games of yesteryear: Super Meat Boy, Castle Crashers, Henry Stickmin, and Minions DLC Friday Night Funkin', Pico School, the popular web series Super Mario Bros. C, my variant is surprisingly bold entry, Madness Combat, Can't Tank Man, Alien Hominid, and The Binding of Isaac. After the nonsensical detour, they finally find the pod. Entering it, they are greeted with nothing but ruins, as the area has been left in disrepair. The pod's door closes and the truth about their existence draws closer. 9 out of 10. A great trip through Newgrounds nostalgia, despite me not experiencing every game feature on here. The pacing is decent, but a little slow at points. A good example being Mario mourning over not Greg, and I still stay up at night wondering how Greg's last field really ended. The humor and parodies are pretty good. How it survives a trip to Brazil by turning out to be a little tribute to the site that contributed online comedy to where it is today, instead of Mario going to the carnival. It's neat on itself, and the ending adds a nice suspenseful bow onto the package. To those thinking that I skipped something in this segment, don't remind me. I've been there. And I gotta tell you what caused it because of how stupid the backlash towards this video was. I already talked about it on the Evil Bird app, so you can look up my tweets on the subject. Let's move on. Within the Guardian pod, Mario and Glitchy find the control room, and like the last time, the former pushes buttons to play back SNG 1 and 2's memory. It happened to be about a point-and-click game named Sputnik's Great Adventure, opening with the main character, Sputnik, who behaves just like Mario, happens to be closely associated with 2 as they start to go on an adventure with his teddy bear. They wrapped into a hub that houses the Newgrounds characters from the previous field. The duo, along with once was that bear that took their teddy, but it fights back. The plumber witnessed the insanity resembling their own adventures, but things immediately go south once an unknown USB crashes down. The visitor is none other than Zero, and grabs Sputnik, draining his life's essence and corrupting 1 and 2, like it almost did to Mario 4 and 3 in the anniversary special. With Sputnik now dead, their world starts to crumble, as he was the Avatar, aka the glue that held everything together. 2 grieves over their loss, but 1 takes it upon himself to stop the monster. 2 gets their paws to evacuate everyone from the destruction, while 1 takes care of the virus. Once they are about to escape, Zero captures 2, but 1 attacks with the paws activating the antivirus to trap the monster. Unfortunately, the door cuts his arm and pushes them into escape pod. In the real world, a human trying to play the game notices their laptop is corrupted, prompting them to move the USB stick to another PC, where they're about to download a Nintendo 64 emulator, and the memory cuts up there. Shocked at their revelations, SG4 tells Mario, if he were to die at the hands of Zero,
the whole universe is going to die!
But the man-child Italian doesn't take it too seriously and they head home safely. However, Zero's eyeball was hiding from them and began to use the controls. It causes the USB to try to seal it to launch from the Toy Toy Kingdom, Sputnik's universe in ruins, to the other universe. What could come next from this point might be not pretty, that's for sure. .5 out of 10. I love the tone balancing in this video. The comedy and the greedy moments go hand in hand. Pacing is good. The SNGs and Sputniks are, or I guess were, pretty interesting. Takes me hype for the arc's finale, but something tells me they're still keeping some key details secret and left us from some damning questions. Was Sputnik's Great Adventure a hidden Newgrounds game, or one of Luke's possible creations made for the story? Was the Toy Toy Kingdom from the original hub for the website, or were the characters representations of assets from those games? And what memories does Zero hold, especially how it became a deadly virus? We'll just have to keep watching and find out. Oh, and about the whole Mario dying thing, I'm very sure Community Desk she shrugged over the years don't count. In that case, the old 101 ways to die video is practically the finale. Yeah, consider this a warning. There's some viewers cherry-picking the story elements in order to make the arc look appealing to their appendage. Way to show your appreciation for your favorite YouTuber, huh? On to the next video.
That sign can't stop me because I can't read!
Strolling back to the Mushroom Kingdom after discovering the universe's origins, Mario and Glitchy come across a fanfiction factory. Of course, since South America is a pretty cursed continent. The Paisano's impulsive curiosity causes him to take more than a look at the toxic waste. And we get a slew of the show's different times taking a page from Marvel. Mario never becomes stupid, and the series doesn't happen. Bob replacing Colonel Sanders. The villains winning their respective arcs. SNG4 having a normal job. Sly and Chris as the Mushroom Kingdom's leaders. Another dive into Mario's pastaless depression. Susie Baka Bob. Psycho as a KFC employee. Why not? Nintendo issuing a cease and desist on the channel, which is really more with the more you think about it, and tells us what a certain individual wants to get away with. Mainly running the channel, Bob acting polite to women, the cast swapping voices. If the show was an anime.
Say Nani again, say Nani one more goddamn time. I double dog dare you, motherfucker.
Nani?
Mario's sausage still attached to the door. Melanie sipping for VeggieTales.
God is dead, and we have killed him.
Everyone turned into Bob. Glitchy high on drugs. I bet there's a theory that the whole series is looking over those comas somewhere. Mario in Persona. Bob and Psycho engaging in a Star Wars fight. And the piece de resistance. If Destiny avoided her terrible fate where things could have gone normal afterwards, until the fake Seraphim is somehow able to survive long enough to take away Maggie instead. Oh yeah, that happened. Appalled as we are, Glitchy freaks out over these ideas in retaliation. It's extremely relatable if you show with the dedicated following, especially one that's a prominent on the internet. 10 out of 10, a weird but hilarious episode poking fun at suggestion takes on the fans' alternate universes. I love just how every skit on here, including the final one, the fact Glitchy lost his mind over so speaks volumes to their self-awareness. It's too bad not everyone gets the memo and still doesn't treat the showrunners with respect, hence why this video feels like they took some risk and how part of their fandom behaves. Not gonna pay repeating myself, so I just say congrats whoever got their submissions approved. Alright, time for the last video. Concluding her vacation in Port Aurora, Maggie arrives back to the Mushroom Kingdom and reunites with her friends. She wants to throw a party for the occasion, but Mario and Bob reluctantly agree due to her house being a hotel. She's surprised and confused up at the establishment at first, but they decide to give her a suit which is better than what anyone could normally afford. During the festivities, she tells her stories about her time away and asks everyone what happened then. Bob was able to keep the hotel running with the service and the critics cooperating. Taking Spanish classes with Swag, lovely, after the dentist incident. Shroomy's Aunt Lady D divorced her husband for his alone time, which is great because Doom is a deadbeat parent. Glitchy turned the basement into a shrine and details the arc's current events. Should we tell him about the eye?
SMG4?
Genesis Arc, science fiction horror mystery story arc on SMG4's channel.
It is the fifth major story arc in the SMG4 series after the Waluigi arc, the Rapper Bob arc, the anime arc, and the YouTube arc. It follows the mystery of the SMGs, the memes, and the zero.
7 months after the events of the YouTube arc, you are attacked by a corrupted Morshu and taken to the internet graveyard where SMG3 gave the place of fate.
Megan Axel and Melanie shop for another bed, and she asks him about their supposed relationship. Maggie visits Psycho's place, the first time you've ever seen it while Bootkin sings her a crappy welcome back song. Finally, she and Mario hang at the skyscraper, talk about her calling 911 via sports coach, It's a sweet spot for helping others in need while accompanying her active lifestyle, which is pretty fitting. After running with a Peter Parker falling on hard times, the pair head home to prepare for a job application in spite of Mario's laziness. And all is well for the record group for about a few weeks. 9 out of 10. Jolly good episode. The beginning and ending are some of the most heartwarming moments of the show. Each segment was brilliant to watch their own energy, humor, and pacing. Though the last one was kind of stretched out to fit the runtime, it shows the cast were able to handle themselves for the most part when the core character is temporarily away. But I would say it was not awkward having her around for the anniversary movie. Besides, Mario made some good banter with her friends. Except Luigi, which didn't tackle for some reason.
Wow! Why does no one pay attention to Luigi?
Yes, this video could benefit from a few fixes. Speaking of fixes, despite the visual improvements being somewhat a rarity in N64, they were able to use John's updated Mega Mind, proving the fan input that can aid the series in some form. Great work! What are you talking about? This video is pretty boring and I hate how disgusting how it is. I thought this was supposed to be a comedy, not some slice of life weep shit by itself.
Shut the hell up!
Another month, another batch review. But of course, something big is gonna happen regarding the future of the series soon. I'll be on top of it next time. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Multi Reviews. And you know the drill. Peace out.